compound inequalities, and one direction. With an and, if both graphs go the same direction, then we use the smaller or you can think of it as being the intersection or overlap. So let's take a look at example one. We'll start by solving. We'll add 6 to both sides. We get 5x is greater than or equal to, well, let's say 26 and 6 is going to give us 32. Divide by 5. We get x is greater than or equal to 32/5. Bring down our and. Let's get our x's on one side here. So we've got 2x plus 1 is greater than negative 9. Whoops. Let's subtract 1 from both sides. We get 2x is greater than negative 10. Divide by 2. And we get x is greater than negative 5. So if we put these in order, negative 5 is here, and 32/5 is over here. Starting with the negative 5, we're going to have an open dot for negative 5, and x is greater than that, so that means it's going to be going to our right. Our 32/5 is going to be a closed dot, and it's going to be going, our x is greater than or equal to, so it's going to also to our right. So that means on our actual graph, when we graph that, we want only where it's overlapping. So that's going to be at our 32/5, and we're going to use the open dot. And we're going to go from 32/5 to infinity. So for our interval notation, that's going to look like 32/5 to infinity. Now let's go to our example 2. First thing we want to do is distribute. We've got 8x plus 8 is greater than 6x plus 2. Let's get our x's on one side. So now we have 2x plus 8 is greater than 2. We'll subtract 8 from both sides. Now I've got 2x is greater than negative 6. Divide by 2, and that means that x is greater than negative 3. I'll bring down our and. And let's get our x's together. So now I have 7 minus 2x less than or equal to 3. Add the opposite to our number. So I now have negative 2x is less than or equal to negative 4. Divide by negative 2. And we now have x is less than or equal to, oops, how about we go greater than or equal to 2. Got to remember to flip when we divide by negative. So let's take a look at what that looks like on a graph. So we have negative 3 and we have a 2. Our negative 3 is going to be an open dot. X is greater than that, so it means we're going to infinity. Our 2 is going to have a closed dot, and x is greater than that, so that means we're also going to positive infinity. So on our actual graph, we want only the overlap. And the overlap's not going to happen until we get to 2. So we're going to have a closed dot at 2. And we're going to go from 2 to infinity. And so our interval notation is going to be from 2 to positive infinity.